Wait, actually, when you turn off the whole passenger lights, the green illuminates. That's so nice. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's funky, I like that. Hello there, guys. It's me, QWERTY Afro, again joined by
me, GamerMike.
Welcome.
I got to sleep for a short period of time.
Welcome back to episode 6 of our Bus Simulator 18 co-op multiplayer series. I hope you guys are enjoying it. We can definitely tell by like the views and the comments and stuff. You guys are really engaged with this series, and we're just gonna be able to make more. And we're definitely enjoying it, kind of playing through the game of like definitely a much better improvement than Bus Sim 16 in terms of the multiplayer aspect, and we're just having a blast here just controlling our own bus company, QA Transport. So in this episode, last episode we kind of completed the whole kind of rural kind of objective and stuff like that. Well, on this next objective, which is farming, we completed that kind of objective that we didn't complete in the previous episode off screen. And now we have these new sets of tasks to do. We have, it's basically, we've unlocked the farming sort of area kind of down here where there's kind of very limited amount of bus stops. There's just basically motorways and stuff like that. And then an agricultural zone, industry zone, and I just still don't think we've unlocked this kind of port amber kind of area here as well. But we've unlocked the kind of industry and agricultural zones when essentially our kind of boss is telling us to make some lines in the agricultural zone and in the industry zone, and then obviously make a kind of route that goes from the agricultural zone to kind of the other zones that we've already made routes in, as well as we have some interesting kind of objectives to do with CNG gas buses, which we actually still haven't unlocked. So that's kind of going to be, it's a bit more of a grindier kind of objective, this one. But at the end, we're going to obviously try and strive to get a gas bus. And then 85% of unlocked bus stops should be on routes which generate income with drivers. So it's a bit of a lengthier one, this one, but we're up for the challenge, me and Mike. So do you want to explain what we have in mind of how we're going to tackle this beginning portion of the current objective, as well as we obviously have a new bus maybe we want to showcase?
Yeah, I mean, can you believe 6 weeks in and we haven't gone bankrupt yet as a new bus company? But what the plan is for this week 6 video is to design a route, I should say, in the farming and industry zone, which we've got to use a minimum of 6 stops, but no more than 8.
Mm.
We're going to do a tag-along mission for that area. You can drive this one and I'll ticket inspect. And then once we've done that, we can move on to the big route, which has to have 8 stops minimum of a maximum of 10.
Yeah,
and that travels pretty much over the map. It just doesn't include the business park area.
Yeah, the Astra Park area, basically. Yeah, all the stuff we did in episode 5, basically, plus the agricultural kind of zone. Basically,
it's going to be a long route, though.
Essentially. But in this episode, we have a new bus we kind of want to showcase as well. And it's, I think, the first ever modded bus that's actually been added onto the workshop and is ready now for us to test and play. It's been on the workshop like basically since the game launched. This is the first, I think, only modded bus, I think, on the workshop. I think there might be an MAN somewhere, but I think that's just a testing kind of bus that the developers uploaded as well. But this is the first kind of user community created bus. It looks really nice from just like the visuals that you can see here right now in our garage. I've added the kind of QA Transport current like color theme, and plus the London buses roundel. As I said in the previous episode, me and Mike would love to showcase some other decals, some other wraps and stuff like that. Please feel free to send us your suggestions in the comments down below, link us to the stuff on the workshop. Would love to kind of get showcase loads of different kind of stuff on the workshop through our series, and this is probably the first one we're going to be doing. Obviously the London roundel is one of them that we just kind of picked out and use on the buses, but this Solaris Urbino 12 is the first kind of thing we're going to be like showcasing off the workshop. I'll leave the link down below so you guys can download it if you have Bus Sim 18 and give it a drive yourself. We don't know anything. We've not tested it before. This is the first time. We literally just bought it before we started recording. And
it's very big, doesn't it?
It does. It looks kind of more meatier than the Sitaro K. It looks like a really nice size standard single floor bus. It doesn't look too small, doesn't look really excessively long like the Cetra. It's kind of like in the kind of middle area there, if you know what I mean. Yeah, but are you excited to kind of give this Urbino 12 Solaris a go? And
it just looks a lot wider. I think it might be difficult to drive around the streets of whatever this city's called. What is this city called? Sunny something, is it? Sunnyvale, I don't know.
Who knows?
Something, you know, crazy.
We just run the buses. We don't need to.
I've created the route.
Oh, you have.
Starting
you? Yeah.
At the sugar mill, and it ends up at the water treatment plant.
Ah, okay.
All exotic sounding places.
Very nice, very nice. So we'll start a co-op trip in this. We'll put in the day because we want to obviously showcase the lovely Solaris Urbino 12. I'll put it as a tag-along mission. I'll invite Mike. Right, yeah, we're in. We are. I like the dot matrix already is completely different to the buses we've driven.
Yeah.
Let me open up door. Oh this interior is spicy. I love the back here. Do you see how like there's this thing here, but I like how it curves around. There's like seats to sit here, and there's like, it's really nicely like ergonomically laid out.
Yeah,
I really like this. I could definitely see a lot of our buses being this in the series.
I've just discovered a problem. I walk through the doors.
Okay. That might be an... Do you see the doors? Do you see the lights? They go red.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that is sick.
And the light goes off.
Oh, that is so cool. It goes red. Oh, I like that. Okay, let's just start and get going, because I can literally
play with it all day. Yeah,
I could. Oh, acceleration's interesting. It's a very kind of like it's like a ship. It kind of gradually builds up. Wait, how did you do that?
No idea. I was just clicking.
Oh my god.
Creepy.
I really like this. You can open the doors for me. This is perfect. 460. Oh, this bus is new. Yes, it is. Of course it is. It's a Solaris Urbino 12. Oh, and it goes green. Oh, that is so cool. This is definitely my new favorite bus, Mike.
Wait, so I fell out the doors.
Oh, wait. Wait, what?
I fell out the doors.
Thank you. Okay, a little bit of an issue for finding out. You know, just bug testing this.
Just got a text. What is Beethoven's favorite fruit?
In multiplayer, this obviously is an issue. The dashboard's nice. It's very Solaris, but some of the dials and buttons are a little bit pixelated. But to be honest, other than that, it's really nice in here. Oh god.
Uh-huh. Aiming for the potholes, brilliant.
Yep. Yeah.
It's got like 30 something seats as well. 30, maybe 6 or so.
I just love those lights that when you close the doors, it's really good.
It's good.
I was thinking about the new superhero block.
Two back. Yes, you can have a ticket. Regular. There you go.
How often do you look?
We all ready to go?
Ready to rock and roll.
Man, those lights are sick. I love it. Whoever made this, thank you. Make more buses.
What is it with this bus? I keep falling out.
There must be a great big hole in this bus or something.
Yeah, there's... Yeah, there's definitely something probably with the multiplayer that obviously...
I'm not going to stand near the doors, I'm gonna sit in a seat.
Yeah. A slightly different horn. Hello, love. Crossing the road like that. Right, give way to the bus, please.
I already showed it.
Give way to the bus, please. Thank you.
I already showed you my ticket.
Got a timetable to stick to.
I already showed
exactly.
It.
We're only 10 seconds. To be honest, we're only 10 seconds late, and we've been already got distracted by the bus, which took some time. So I'd say not too bad.
We managed to be about 15 minutes late.
Like the sounds. The sounds are kind of nice. Really, really nice.
That's my stop.
And you get the nice whole, little matrix display on the dashboard that has everything simulated. It very, very much so reminds me of, when I drive these type of buses in OMSI with all the kind of stuff. It's quite nice.
The game might break.
Yeah. But I think one thing when you drive this, you'll see the acceleration's it's not instant. It's it feels like that hybrid kind of thing where it kind of gradually moves off.
Kicks in.
Yeah.
Electric kicks in.
But it's nice. I would think it would probably be very comfortable to be in this bus.
I'm out for driving. I'm a maniac.
Yeah. Oh, and when you stop, the lights go green. Sure, I like that. I'm just loving everything about this bus. It's just so good.
What do you think of the route?
The route's nice, but it's very industrial, isn't it? Okay, so the cockpit lights don't work.
How often do you want?
Student, there you go.
Thank you. I think I'll need several.
Day senior, three of them. Nice.
Thanks.
There you go. Oh, did I?
I think you opened the door again.
Oh, did I not open it?
No, it's definitely open.
Oh, okay. Oh yeah, I'm loving these sounds. Right, we're outside of the agriculture center now. We're gonna head to the... what's the other place? The industrial zone.
Industry.
Wait, did I hit?
Is it that corner brilliantly?
Oh, it didn't tell me that I hit.
It was like a lamppost.
Very nice. And the steering wheel's not as chunky as the other ones that we've tried out on other buses, very thin.
Sounds good.
Yeah, it does.
How dare you have a coffee and then drop your garbage?
Right, coming into the industrial zone, or Port Amber.
How often do you want?
Of course.
You saw my ticket already. I already
see it again.
You saw my here. What? You saw my ticket already.
Well, it's not Port Amber, is it? We haven't unlocked that.
Well, I think the whole area is Port Amber, but it's the industrial bit first, yeah.
I hate the commercial breaks in Winter of Passion. They always come right after a cliffhanger.
Hurry up, we're late.
And now somehow we're 2 minutes late, which is interesting.
If you're taking the corner too slowly. There's a great big scratch on the outside there from that lamppost.
Really?
Really? Thank you. I need to purchase
Oh my god, these seniors are just rinsing me with these tickets today.
Very old, aren't they?
They might forget to buy a ticket, that's why they buy so many. Oh, I love these green lights. And they go off nice.
Excuse me, could you open the door again?
Oh my god. Come on, mate. Get out.
In the middle of the road.
Yep.
You really need to see the view down at the harbor.
Oh, we're near the harbor, aren't we?
It's all within this area, I think, yeah.
Booze Corp Warehouses. Next station.
Station.
I can't wait for you to give a ride in this and tell me your opinion of it. Okay. Oh, actually, when I go into the external camera, I can see your hands kind of like cut through the bus. That's great. Yeah.
I've got one hot hand that needs to be outside constantly.
Oh, no. I went the wrong way.
Oh, wow. Look at this. Sorry about the
Sorry.
Migration, people.
And nice, he does it. Pardon me, sorry, excuse-moi.
You don't see that happen every day, do you know? Sort of in real life.
Oh, I've seen this happen.
Really?
It doesn't happen this messy. Like, but I've seen drivers go down wrong ways and they've had to reverse.
Yeah, I don't think they turn around like you did.
No.
Has to be done. Somebody has a ladybug on their knee. Which means there's a ladybug on this bus.
That's lovely. Nature.
Oh, I forgot to water my plants.
Oh, this is a bit of sharp turn. But executed very well by me.
Wait for the weekend to begin.
Wow, weekend. Perfect parking.
There's quite a few people on this bus. It's quite a popular route.
Yeah. Have to add some more drivers to it.
Bye. I'm assuming we haven't tried it yet, but with the game, can we add multiple buses to one route?
And yeah, I would think so. Yeah, I would think so.
It's not just one driver.
Thanks.
Yeah, we should do that, actually. Just find, like, maybe test out, like, by putting a driver on every route and then seeing what route makes the most money.
I'd imagine ones that probably longer bus routes, for example, coming from the main bus station.
Yeah.
Maybe all the way to the business park. Yeah. Via all those stops, you'd want a couple of buses.
Because I guess a route that's had a driver on it for a long time as well was more established.
Mm.
Compared to like a new route.
And who wants one bus per week when you could have two or three?
Yeah.
Oh, we've not got any ticket.
No Dodgers today.
Yeah, that's the word. Of course. Here you go. Oh, there's one.
Wait, where did my hat go?
I'm driving with locked doors. Did you lock the doors?
Yeah. I accidentally,
Goodbye.
Beautiful.
It's
that is quite a lot of people. Come on, guys, get out.
The end of the route? Wow.
Yeah.
That was very quick.
Yeah. Swift.
It's a nice looking bus from the outside as well.
Yeah, it is.
I don't think we appreciated the outside of that enough then. We were just looking at the inside.
Oh, we've made a lot of money on that. 27.
Yeah.
That's quite a lot for that kind of route. Yeah.
That's a lot of people.
It's not bad. Not bad at all. Let's see how our drivers are doing. So, 4 grand on the line 7. 9 on the Astra, the number 1. 9 on that. 6 is doing really well. 10 grand.
That's so, we need to make a new route as well, don't we know? That long route.
Yes, we do. Yes, we do.
Should I go ahead and make it?
I'll make it for you. You made that route for me to drive. I'll make this new route. Do you want to start at the agricultural zone, or do you want to start at like Oakville, kind of north?
Yeah, I think we should start with the farmyard.
The agricultural zone, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll do
start at the farm.
I'll do the one that you didn't do, the Nutrivore Research Lab. An interesting name. So I have to have 2 stops in that, then I have to have 2 stops in Scoba Grounds, which I think we'll just end up doing the 2 along the river. I think be the best. No.
The old sawmill in all of this as well.
Actually, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to make it even more interesting. We're going to go. We're going to finish in Sober Ground, and we're going to go first. We're going to go to. We're going to go to Seigwalden.
Interesting.
And then we're going to go to like Oakville. I'm going to miss. I'm going to miss 1 stop in Oakville. Actually, is the sawmill part of Oakville?
I'm not sure. It'll tell you when you've completed it. If it puts a tick in there, that means you've created it.
Okay. I'm missing 1 of the stops in Oakville, and then we will finish at Workers' Alley in there. And if we save that... Okay, that does it. Do you like that route I made?
Oh, it's come up in red.
Yeah. Nutrivore Research Labs to Workers' Alley in Shoba Grounds.
That looks brilliant, doesn't it? It's nice and long.
Yeah, it is. So if you want to invite me to do a tag-along in the Solaris, you can do the honours of driving and christening this new route. I'm pretty sure it's going to make us a lot of money. It's going through quite
really
a lot.
Long,
it's a bit of stuff, yeah.
With a brand new bus as well. So we're doing a tag-along, are we?
Yeah, we'll do a tag-along. I'll support you and I'll drive in the beautiful interior. Right, I'm ready for this. I'm ready
all
to...
All aboard?
I get to see the lights now all the time.
Yeah, in all of their glory.
I love that. It's a nice little feature. It's not like anything amazing, but I love it.
Let's see what you mean about the acceleration actually just then.
It's smooth. It's really smooth. Like it's
quite slow though.
Yeah, it's not instant, but it's smooth.
The steering feels quite heavy.
Hmm.
In comparison to what I've driven, such as the Sitaro and the Setra.
Yeah.
It just feels a little heavier.
Yeah.
Looks nice though, the bus looks great on the outside.
Mm.
I love the sloping window screen from the driver's side down to the doors.
Yeah, it's a nice little kind of design kind of cue.
Mm, you can get off and show that later on.
Yeah, dude, I could do even now actually, like it's a nice little slash here. I think that's a trait of Solaris buses. They have that kind of really flat, kind of tapered kind of front.
Did you catch your lights?
Oh, that's beautiful, yeah. Oh, actually, when you turn off the whole passenger lights, the green illuminates. That's so nice. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's funky, I like that.
Groovy. It's like a disco.
Imagine, like, you know there's a thing with the customizations where you can actually customize the interior. Or that might be something that you could like mod and put into the workshop, but like it'd be so cool if you could add like items and stuff to your interior and customize your interior like fully, like how a bus company would.
So we could have a set of fluffy dice.
Yeah, or like disco lights.
It'd be nice to be able to change the like the cover seat covers and the
yes
to the color of the handlebars or whatever you want to call them
to like match your company's kind of aesthetic.
Yeah, your livery as such.
Oh, the brakes are a bit weak, aren't they?
Yeah, I like everything. The word really with this bus is gradual. It's very soft.
If I whack the park brake on, I'm sure it'd be counted as harsh braking.
Yeah, but. We're hitting the curb a bit, Mike. Right. Goodbye, guys. Thank you for joining us.
He's not a student. He's about 50.
He could be a student. Are you being ageist, Mike?
Well,
you could be a student in 50.
Can I see a student card then, please? Alright, shall I turn the lights to consider the red illuminate?
If you want, yeah. Oh,
just for your
nice
benefit.
That's nice, thank you. I enjoyed that greatly. Oh, and you can actually go to the very back of this bus, unlike some of the other buses. Yeah, I'm literally like on the step here before these two last back seats.
I was too scared to, because I kept falling out of the doors.
Oh no! I already showed you my ticket.
Should we see how this picks up speed then on this long road?
Sure. Yeah, we could.
What?
Here you go.
Sure.
I already showed you my ticket.
It feels just very heavy, doesn't it? Like it's about 3,000 tons.
It is a big bus. It's not like a small bus, like the Starro. Oh, that gearbox is whining.
Yeah. Avoid that pothole.
Some of these textures in here are a little bit glitchy.
Are they?
A little bit, like it's very subtle, not noticeable, but when you do look a little bit hard, it does. There are some stuff.
What have you discovered?
I don't know. It's like when we're in motion, some of the textures get like fuzzed or something like that. I don't know. It's just,
you can stand on the seats a little bit as well. Is that green cardigan?
You can stand on the steps before the seats.
Yeah. Oh, I managed to glitch onto the seat and my head stuck out at the top of the bus, but I didn't tell you that. Oh.
Next stop, Siegwallen.
It's a nice bus, I quite like it.
Yeah, I do. I think we should.
Well done to whoever made this.
Yeah. Bravo for using Unreal Engine.
Mmm.
Hope he or she makes some more.
Somebody left a coffee cup there.
Oh, where?
There.
Oh, yes, yep, got it. Oh, what is this little red box here? It's like, I think it's some sort of ticket machine, I think.
Where is it?
It's like literally behind the first right two seats. Yeah, I think it's some sort of like ticket machine that people would like stamp their ticket on or something, and like the actual real purpose life of this bus.
So it's a Royal Mail post box. That's what it is, right there.
Oh no!
Are you all aboard?
Yeah. Just hopped on in time.
Sounds of panic behind me. So I don't know what's going on?
It's fine. I got there.
Sorry.
Thank you.
I heard that the other day when I was playing, and it was a case of classical music, and they were like headbanging to it, just that it was out of place.
Oh, there's our Setra.
Setra.
I don't know who's driving it, but
I think it might be Michael.
Oh, he flashed as well. That's such a cool thing, just having a bus driver's flash at you. That's so cool. Go on, Michael.
Michael the Apprentice.
I think one or two of them are not apprentices anymore. Like, their wages actually had to go up. We have to pay them more.
Crikey. Let's sack them and then get some more apprentices.
Just keep everything cheap.
Yeah.
It's cost
cutting, things like that.
Cost cut.
If there's some employers watching, they'll be considering, let's just all employ people who are below the age of 19 or whatever.
Yeah.
It's all cheap.
Yeah, and I think this matrix display as well, it's static. It's not like the other ones, which are like moving displays. This is like just it shows the whole information on the thing, and the one on the side here, if it's too long, it just gets cut out.
Oh, so it doesn't like do a reel of what it's.
No, it's just one of those. It's just like shows everything.
Time to go.
Yep. Oh, you didn't wait for the green light, Mike.
Here you go.
Yeah, well, we're 2 minutes late now. 55 seconds late, so...
Yeah.
And there's gonna be traffic at the end of the street, so I can see it building up.
Oh my god, another one.
I wish they'd, not bring their music with them.
Definitely. I think the sawmill's the next station.
Oh. I just crashed and got £3,000. I didn't crash into anything.
Wait, what?
Maybe this bus is so low to the ground that it just crashes into the ground.
Invisible car?
Could be. That's the Oak Street next, and then it's the old sawmill.
Yeah.
I'm expecting to see some sort of palace. Because they talk about it so much in the game.
Yeah.
Go. I'm very late now.
How much?
2 minutes as of this stop. So I was 55 seconds late.
You know, you should have implemented my tactic, Mike. You should have closed the first door and just let everyone come in for the second door.
I can't because she's in the way.
Well, that's just tough. And maybe implement it at the sawmill. Just open the back door only.
There we go.
There you go. Right. Good. Good stuff.
Here's the ticket.
Here you go. Of course. Here you go.
Here. That's slow. I already showed. Of course. It can't take off very well on a hill.
Maybe this is just a city bus for flatland.
It's trying to push a tank up a hill. Literally. Oh, this looks nice. It's in the forest.
Oh yeah. Looks like.
Should we pull over and have a picnic?
I think we'll save that for another episode. Can't be too consistent with those picnics.
Oh, I know. So this is the sawmill.
Yeah.
Like a big concrete slab for a bus stop.
Yeah, I kind of want to go and find this sawmill.
I reckon it'd be up the top of that hill.
You wanna join with?
Just wait for the passengers.
Oh, okay. Not what I was expecting. I was actually like thinking it was like a mill, but it's like some sort of like abandoned, well not abandoned, but like a warehouse, and I guess concerts and stuff go ahead here.
Wow, no wonder people speak of it so much. It's amazing. How you get in and out of that car park though is
interesting.
Let's have a race back to the bus. 3, 2, 1, go.
Well, we both run at the same speed, so we're not gonna.
Yeah, I know.
Well, that's good. I like that. Nice little bit of game story there.
Yeah. Not visible from the road though.
No, but it's a nice little track. Like it's nice. It's hidden.
Easter egg.
Yeah.
I think I'm going to win this race.
Yeah, I think you are. Oh, a bus looks nice.
Look at the traffic jam you've caused.
Wow. Nice. I like that. We discovered what everyone seems to talk about on our buses.
The old sawmill.
Your stomach. Are you going to be sick, sir?
Please. Oh, that's a pothole there. I already showed you my ticket.
Imagine if people were sick. Oh, imagine like on night bus routes if people just vomited and we had to clean it up.
That's disgusting.
Yeah, but it's realistic.
Okay. Get your gloves on.
Yeah. We should hire cleaners.
Yeah. There's a feature.
There's loads of features that you could add.
Did you catch the concert last night at the old sawmill? Oh, look, the old sawmill. The band seemed to be just sleepwalking
their way through it. We were just there. It's a band. Oh, that that traffic down there was not nice.
From that mirror, actually, from your seated position, you can't see any of the road. It's just the bush you can see.
Really?
Hmm.
Invisibility might be an issue, yeah.
Adjust that mirror.
Yeah, there's some of these textures in here that do glitch when the bus is moving. So obviously, this maybe a bit needs a bit more refinement.
It's a good job. Well done there.
Oh yeah. Right, only the back door, Mike. Oh, okay.
Oh, yes.
That's fine.
Hurry up, we're late.
There we go. How does it feel not to have any work?
Well, there appears to be a traffic jam.
Oh, yeah.
People.
Of course. All the people that need to come out need to come out, and then everyone that needs to go in will go in.
If only the passengers knew, look.
Yeah, if they knew.
That if you only could, they knew.
If they could, phase through the front door.
I don't think they wanted to get on.
Nah. Alright, let's go, last stop. Quite a long route, but it felt pretty swift, to be honest.
It's because I'm a great driver.
Yeah, that is a factor there.
Great driver, and I'm a good mechanic as well.
Solaris Urbino 12 has been driven in, and I think we definitely like it. 32,000, wow. Damn.
That was after a collision with that invisible vehicle.
Yeah.
Only one fare, Dutcher.
Yeah, there wasn't many.
I hit a lot of potholes.
Oh, guys, I'm making money. Oh, number 5 is now making a lot of money. 11k, nice. We have quite a lot of money, actually. Why are we not going bankrupt?
That's why we're rich now. Look at all this.
Jesus. We've made like almost 580,000 in income. That's pretty good. And we've transported about 520 people. It's quite nice. Doing some good stuff here. And then essentially the last bits of the objective is to assign at least one driver, only assign CNG buses, and drive a route with a CNG bus. I don't think we have the CNGs yet unlocked, unfortunately. I think the next bus along... What's that? That's the...
It's the CNG.
It's the... Yeah, it's that one, that level 9. So we start...
Which looks like it's got no seats at all.
Oh my god. Oh my god, that looks horrid inside.
Looks like an airport passenger.
Well, yeah, it looks like just standing. I like the design of it, it's very funky. But the inside, it looks like it's just standing capacity only, really. Maybe something we can do, obviously it's going to take us a bit of time to get level 9 to unlock that CNG bus, but I think for the next episode, it'll be really cool to maybe get the Lion City A37, hire some more drivers, maybe get all our routes like assigned with drivers, maybe some of the more popular profitable routes, get like a couple more drivers assigned to it, get some more Sitaro Ks, or maybe even start buying up Solaris Urbinos, who knows.
Or you know, it will have level 9 and
that
gas.
CNG bus. Which just looks like a cattle mobile. I could just like literally like maybe only 40% of the bus is seating. The rest looks just standing. It's crazy.
Have you seen the extra large Setra?
The extra large Setra. I know after that CNG bus, it's a nice Sitaro G, which is basically our Sitaro K, but just longer. So that's, we like the Sitaro, so we're definitely looking forward to that. Then, oh my god. It just has an extra wheel. It just has an extra wheel.
It's much longer as well.
It's basically a bendy bus, but just without anything bendy in it, really.
And all that bits of drive.
Yeah. And then we have the cattle, the bendy cattle bus, which oh, it looks like it has more seating though. Looks like it has.
Because it's longer.
Yeah, it's longer. That literally the back part of the bendy portion of the bus has more seating than the actual single decker. That's crazy. And then after that, it's a it's the Lions City CNG, which is basically the bendy bus of the Lions, and that looks crazy. That looks ridiculously long. That is like, look how many doors it has. That's five double leaf doors.
And it seats 39 and stands 40.
It's crazy. And obviously the Solaris Urbino, which is unlocked for us for the workshop. I hope more people make buses to add to the workshop. I know the guy that's making OMSI London, he's actually ported over one of his double-decker buses to the Unreal Engine for this game. I don't know where along the development it is, but he definitely wants to add a double-decker bus to this game. So maybe at some point when he gets time after kind of dealing with OMSI London, he'd probably publish a double-decker bus for this game, which would be really exciting. I hope more people modern supplier. It would.
I wonder if the upper deck will have doors and they just fall out.
Yeah, or like, how would it work? Would you be able to go up the stairs of the double deck? I don't know. That's going to kind of work out. That would be an interesting thing to kind of to see. But guys, I hope you guys have enjoyed episode 6. We definitely enjoyed giving you a little bit of a showcase of the Solaris Urbino 12. We've completed the nice three objectives here on the farming objective. As you said, probably the next episode we'll probably just grind and do a bit of driving in the MAN. We might get some more drivers and stuff like that. Just basically get some more money and get some more XP and stuff like that to get to level 9 to unlock the CNG buses so we can basically do then the CNG mission. But yeah, Mike, it's been good. It's been good. Episode 6 has been good. I look forward to doing episode 7 with you.
And hopefully we'll never go bankrupt.
Yeah, that's the ideal aim, just to never go bankrupt. But I think we're doing really well, so you know, just need to improve on things like some punctuality, improve like not crashing and stuff like that. But other than that, we're making money, so
it's a positive outlook.
It's a positive outlook, exactly. But yeah, hope you guys have a lovely day, whatever you're doing, and thank you very much for supporting the series till now. We'll definitely be making more, and we're definitely enjoying this. I hope you guys are too. And again, just keep us entertained in the comments, give us suggestions and stuff of what you guys want us to showcase from the workshop. Give any suggestions of how maybe you would want to run QA transport, and we might even take it on board. But we'll see you guys in episode 7. We hope you have a lovely day. Take care. See ya.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna be a little calm on this one. Okay, watch on my wrist, skate in my Vans, flow so sick, put the flies in the van. Maserati body on my Scotty too. Hottie got the fam that's overseas. So if I